गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, आई एम गंगाधर राव फ्रॉम जेआर स्टडी सर्कल हैदराबाद। टुडे आई विल टीच यू सम बेसिक्स ऑफ इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज। नाउ ऑल ऑफ यू नो इंग्लिश एज अ लैंग्वेज एज एंटर्ड इन आवर कंट्री थ्रू द ब्रिटिशर्स आई नीड नॉट टेल यू दैट देर आर 26 लेटर्स इन इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज and all these letters are together known as alphabet. Now, why did I write this? The reason is that most of us usually say that alphabets. No, alphabet in Telugu we call it as Varnamala, or in Hindi also we call it as Varnamala. We will not call it as Varnamalalu. So, Varnamala, alphabet means what? Varnamala, or the set of 26 letters in English is known as alphabet. So, you are not supposed to say alphabets. If you say alphabets, then that means that the different number of alphabet of different languages. If 2-3 languages are there, then we can say that alphabets. But when we are talking of only one language, that is English, then you are not supposed to say that alphabets. What you are supposed to say is alphabet. Right? Now, next, there is a word, it is known as word. What is word? Group of letters. So, 2 or 3 or 4 or any more number of letters will come together to form a word. For example, pen. Pen has 3 letters. Pen has 3 letters. So, this we call it as pen. Play. Play has how many letters? 1, 2, 3, 4. So, we call this as a word. These are known as words. Now these words come together to form a sentence. Sentence. What is a sentence? It is a group of words. It is a group of words. Now simply if I say that pen, play, atom, like this, if I go on writing number of words, group of words, can that make a sentence? No. That should give some sense, some meaning, complete meaning. So, complete meaning. For example, Raju plays football. Raju plays football. Now, remember, 1, 2, 3. Or for that matter, football, if you take it as one word, then it is 3. If you take as football as separate word, then it is 4. But usually we take it as 1 because the ball which is played in the game of football is regarded as football. Right? So, 3 words are there. So, these 3 words coming together, they form the sentence because they make some sense. They give sense. They give complete meaning. They make some sense. They make some sense or give complete meaning. Give complete meaning. Okay, so the first thing is words, the second thing is complete meaning. They give complete meaning. And what is important in that is that subject, the one Raju is known as the subject and the remaining part is known as the predicate. So subject and predicate are present. So what are the qualities of a sentence? The sentence is a group of words. It is a group of words with a subject and predicate and gives complete meaning. It gives complete meaning. Then we call it as sentence. So remember, word is a group of letters that refer to an object or thing. Then sentence is group of words which gives some meaning, complete meaning, and it also has a subject and predicate. Then we call this as sentence. Okay, so what we have learned today is about the alphabet, about words and then sentences. About words and then sentences. Let us go a little further. example, just now I told you that sentences, a group of words with a subject and predicate that gives complete me. Now, after that, suppose I will say on the floor. So, you know that there are three words. So, it is a group of words. It is fulfilling the first condition. Is there any subject on this? No. So, it is not fulfilling the second condition. Does it give complete meaning? No. It gives some meaning, some sense. On the floor means we will look at the floor. So, on the floor, in some sense, but not complete sense, then such kind of things, they are known as phrases. They are known as what? Phrases. So, this is also a group of words. Does it have a subject and predicate? No. No subject, no predicate. So, without a subject or predicate, and gives that use, okay, that use, and use some in bracket but incomplete, it gives some meaning, okay, but incomplete meaning. So this cannot be regarded as a sentence, this cannot be regarded as a sentence, okay. Now next it is, I will say, I went to market but the market was closed. Now you can see that the whole sentence is a sentence, but however, if I make it as two parts, both of them give complete meaning. For example, I went to market, it is a complete meaning giving sentence, its subject is there, predicate is there, group of words is there, and it is giving complete meaning. And similarly, if I say the market was closed, subject is the market, was closed is the predicate. So, some group of words, subject, predicate, and also it is giving complete meaning, but it is part of a sentence. Then we call it as a clause. So, here what it is? A group of words with, again this is with, because subject and predicate are there, with a subject and predicate and gives, here it is giving complete meaning, so we will call it as gives complete meaning. It is giving complete meaning. But you can see that in some other sentences, these clauses do not give complete meaning. So I will write like this. See, if I divide the sentence like this, you can say that this is giving complete meaning. But when I add like this, then it is giving incomplete meaning. When the market was about to be closed, if I say that, then it is not giving any complete meaning. Then we call it as this also as a clause. So there are two varieties of clauses. The second one is and gives incomplete meaning. So this type of things are known as main classes, and this type of classes are known as subordinate classes. This type of things are known as subordinate classes. So you can see that in classes there are two varieties, main classes and subordinate classes. And main classes is almost equal to a sentence, except that it is part of a sentence, and subordinate class does not give complete meaning. However, it gives more meaning than a phrase, more meaning than a phrase. Just now, for the example of phrase, we said on the floor. Example, on the floor. So on the floor gives some meaning, but not that much of meaning as a class. Class gives more meaning. So class is between, we can say that class is between phrase and a sentence. Okay? So this is about the basics of English grammar. The basics of English grammar. And one more mistake that usually people tend to do is grammar spelling. When they are writing A, they write E. It is not E, but it is A. And always remember, whenever you are writing the name of a subject or language, then you are supposed to write the first letter as capital. The first letter as capital. Okay? So these are the different topics in the beginning, in the basics of English grammar. So we have studied what is a word and what is a sentence, and then what are the parts of a sentence, subject and predicate, and then phrase, and then class. Now we are supposed to study subject and predicate, which we will study a little later. In the next topic, I will explain you what is subject and what is predicate. Okay? Now, so friends, today we have discussed about English, some basics of the English grammar. I have told you about what is an alphabet, why you should not say alphabets, and then how many letters are there in English alphabet, and how letters come together to form a word, and words coming together to form a sentence. And I have also discussed with you what makes a sentence or phrase or a class. A phrase is the one which is a group of words with a subject and predicate, and that gives complete meaning. And then coming to phrase, then it is also a group of words, but there is no subject or predicate in that, and it does not give complete meaning, but it does make some sense. And then coming to class, the class is almost equal to a sentence in that sense that it is also a group of words, it has a subject and it has a predicate, and it gives complete meaning. So, but why we call it as a class? Because it is part of a sentence. However, there are some more types of classes wherein, though they have the subject and predicate and group of words, they do not give complete meaning. Then they are known as subordinate classes. The ones which give complete meaning are known as main classes, and the ones which do not give complete meaning are known as subordinate classes. More about these classes, phrases and sentences, and I'm also supposed to tell you what is meant by subject and predicate. Okay, so I will tell you them, all of them, in the coming classes. So for now, today, this is what is the basics of English grammar. Thank you, friends.